Hey there and welcome to another Dave Does video. Today we're doing a covers versus original, and again we are doing Godsmack. We've just recently done Godsmack Awake versus Asleep, and we are now checking out Godsmack Re-Align versus Re-Align. And this is basically Re-Align from the album. We're going to pick a live performance for this one versus Godsmack Re-Align Acoustic, where they did this album called The Other Side, where they took their songs or a selection of their songs and reimagined them in acoustic format. So we're going to go check this one out. If you like the video, please do subscribe. Subscribe, click the like or like, share, leave the comments down below, get involved with the challenges, top 10 challenge, and of course the covers versus original. If you'd like to support the channel, you can do so via the Patreon, the priority video requests, the Rotten Inside Craft Shop, and of course Bandcamp from Nothing Gained. If you'd like to also check out some of the music that I'm currently working on, you can check out Project 42, and if you'd like to download any of the songs that we've worked on this channel, some of the original content stuff, they are also available via the Reverb Nation Project 42 site. We're going to count this one in. This is Godsmack Re-Align live. I do know the song, so it's not a scored reaction, but I'll give you my thoughts about what I think of the song at the end. Counting it in, 3, 2, 1, go! Can't remember if I've actually seen this live version. Oh, was this off of the Oracle? Toolbox. Shannon Larkin, one of my favourite drummers. It's just like human octopus. It's just such energy for a real, like, it's like wiry. He's a wiry guy. He does his head moves too slow. Just everything's like punching dynamic. The chorus is just kind of very chilled. Leads to a lot of emotion. Strong dynamics of track, just punchy as hell. Yeah.
great.
See, for me, it's Sully and Shadow that really kind of holds the live performance. Not getting a huge amount off the other two. Try to figure what the bass player's name is. You can't off the way down, do you know it? It's kind of got a vibe to it, it just doesn't really interact, engage with the audience much. Okay, so Godsmack and Realign Live. A great track, really enjoy it. Love the energy, love the kind of the vibe and the chorus. It just has that big kind of uplifting, but also real emotional kind of vibe to it. We're going to go check out the acoustic version and just see how they interpret it. It's shorter, so I'll be intrigued to see why. Probably because they'll say, yeah, there was an intro of about 30 seconds. That's probably going to be about the same length then. But let's see what the comparisons are between the two. Let's get it up on the screen. Give me one sec. 3, 2, 1, go! Think this one actually works slightly better having it on the acoustic, just because it's just the punchiness and the harmonizing works better for the two of them. And you can really hear what's going on with Shannon on the drums. Grab those in ears. It's not exactly like he's not restraining himself from the drum kit, there is he? Hit those strings hard on the acoustic to solo it. Who it is they got to play the rhythm guitar on this bit? So obviously it's normally Sully Chris plays it. Let's go. Question though, why did Sully play the acoustic on this one? Let me know if you know the reason in the comments. One concert I'd have loved to have gone to. Love it when bands just strip back their songs. Very cool. So Godsmack, re-align, acoustic.
Thank you.
So you can probably guess that my favourite out of the two versions is the acoustic, just because I liked the vibe of it. It's more of a chill. It's kind of the live version's fine, and the recorded, the normal amp version are great. I love both versions. I just prefer this one because it's more of a kind of a chill vibe to it. It's kind of just a little bit more of a groove, whereas the other one's kind of more a little bit more kind of hard rock. Probably better for me when I'm driving. I'd probably listen to kind of the live version or the album. For the acoustic, is probably more something when I'd probably just listen around the house and stuff like that. So it's just when I want to more relax out. But they pretty much stayed dead on exactly what they were doing on the both versions. So they didn't really change this one up. Whereas with when they did Asleep, versus Awake, they did do some changes to the instrumentation, just kept the lyrics, so bit of a difference there, but I really like what Godsmack do, and it was good fun to check it out. But let me know what you think. Hopefully this might be a new experience, or it's a new band for you, and let me know what you think in the comments down below. If you like the video though, please do subscribe, click the bell icon, like, share, leave the comment, and get involved with the challenges. Thank you very much for watching, and that of course is how Dave does it. Let's go.